Hey friends, my name is Aki Dearest. So I'm super excited because yesterday a new promotional video for a new app came out called Pokemon Go. The long and the short of it, it's basically an app that has now granted the wish and prayers of many 90s kids. We can now capture Pokemon in real life! No, that doesn't mean that Pokemon have now been invented or discovered. But it's an app that actually puts us through the simulation of capturing Pokemon.
It's so beautiful, isn't it?
Before I get into the mechanics of how the game would work,
I'm going to tell you guys first off that it was made by the company Niantic.
Yeah, I don't know who that company is either. But I do know that they're famous for making the app game Ingress. Now, if you're unfamiliar with Ingress, it's basically an app where you physically have to go outside and it's essentially capture the flag, but on a worldwide scale. The app notifies the player of all these different things called portals where you have to capture them, and there's different tactics that you can do, and you actually can collaborate and play with other players all around the world or just with your friends and family. I actually had the pleasure of going to a panel over the weekend at a convention where it actually went over the mechanics and the gameplay of Ingress. But I wasn't feeling it because I just didn't like the idea that I had to physically go out to different areas and different distances in order to win, because I'm more of an indoor junkie. So for a game and I have to actually travel outside and to different places in order to play this, However, when you throw Pokemon in there, then now you've created some kind of successful marketing strategy. So right into how the game works. You download the app on your smartphone or your Android, and you physically, as a person, have to physically get outside of your house and either walk around your neighborhood, your city, or your town, and it will notify you if a Pokemon is close to you. Now here's where the good part comes in. You will then get to challenge and capture these Pokemon.
It's so beautiful.
Now hold on to your Shimapon because it doesn't stop there. I was looking at an article and it looks like that they're actually trying to work on what's called the Pokemon Go Plus. And it's a bracelet that the app users actually have an option of getting, which notifies them of the same things of whether or not there's an event or a Pokemon around them. So now you won't even have to be on your smartphone in order for this to work. Now I can actually feel like a Pokemon trainer. Now as far as how many Pokemon are in the game, looking at the promotional videos and looking at a little bit more of the article, it looks like that they're sticking with the original 150 Pokemon, which that's actually a pretty good start. Considering Pokemon's biggest fan base is pretty much anyone from the 90s to early 2000s. Basically the people that were there during the original 150 to 151 Pokemon. Now I was actually having a suggestion on this game that I was talking about with my friend, and looking more into the article, it looks like that they actually might be incorporating this into the game. But I was saying that it'd be really cool that if on the app you can get certain types of Pokemon if you're in a certain type of environment. So for example, I live in Las Vegas, Nevada, and we're pretty much just desert. So I expect that I'd probably get a lot of Sandshrews and Diglets. But if I wanted to get any grass-type Pokemon, then I'd actually have to physically go to a park or any grassy area or a forest anywhere here in Las Vegas. And then I can probably get the option of getting a Caterpie or a Butterfree. But then why would I get a Caterpie if I can just get a Butterfree? I'll just string shot everybody until I evolve. The concept of Ingress and Pokemon Go is for gamers to actually go out and physically do something, which is something that not a lot of gamers really do. Because I'm more of an indoor junkie myself, it's definitely a great idea and a contribution to the gaming community. And then there's also a community and social experience rewarded in all of this. One more con that I have to this though, and correct me if I'm wrong because there's not a lot of detail yet put out for the game, but in the promotional video towards the end, there's a big gathering in New York Times Square, it looks like, and they all spot a Mewtwo. And then they all capture Mewtwo? I don't know how I feel about the whole fact of multiple people actually capturing one Pokemon, because I think that it should actually be more of a competitive thing. But hey, I could be wrong, or I actually might turn out to like it. Anyways, that's really all that I could cover for this app. I can't wait to get it. I'm definitely going to order it as soon as it comes out. I'll put a link in the description to the promotional video, and then just put a comment down below of what you guys think of the app. Or if there's anything that I got wrong or left out, just put it down there too. Anyways guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!